etiquette. Etiquette is the word. Elevator etiquette, escalator etiquette, sidewalk etiquette. It's America. We walk on the right. Trooper. Yo, today is Tuesday. Tuesday. All kind of echo action going. And I got a little reveal for you. Just a little reveal. Gonna reveal something. You ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? What? Trooper, no you didn't. No you didn't. You ain't got a new t-shirt for Go Gamble Shop, do you? Just some Go Gamble Blend right here. Go Gamble Blend. Hallelujah, Go Gamble Blend. What's all this snapping going on? I think it's cause it's raining men. No, remember in Living Color? Men on poker. No?
Two snaps up in a circle.
Zorro snap
in Z formation.
Around the world and back snap.
Chef Boyardee snap.
Two snaps and wipe your mouth.
Available in four colors right now on GoGambleShop.com. There's a secret embedded in this shirt, though. There's a secret. Some of you will know what it is. Some of you might not know what it is. What's the secret? What's the secret of the shirt? Huh? I'm gonna tell you one day, but I want you to figure it out for yourself first. I'll tell you what, there are clues in a, what am I hitting buttons? There are clues all throughout the vlog. It's Tuesday. I think I already mentioned that. Oh, wow. That was a big speed bump. I'm on the Las Vegas Strip. Where else would I be? It's Gloria and Joe.
In Keller, Texas.
Keller, Texas?
Yes, sir.
Nice.
Shout out to our boys, Javier and Josh, and our Basset Hound, Pete.
Pete. Keep Pete away from the
get
sparkly box.
The 100 vlog.
Oh, yeah, I will.
Okay.
Well, thanks a lot. Good to meet you.
Thank you. Nice
to
meet you.
Good luck if you're gambling or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Out here in front of the volcano at the Mirage. For some reason, it's like extra humid today. It feels muggy. It feels like I'm in Florida. Well, it's not quite that bad. Let's have a look, though. Looks like it's 104 right now. No, it's 106. Where's the humidity action? It just says partly cloudy. How the hell are you supposed to know the daggone humidity, yo? Who knows? It feels muggy, though. And it normally doesn't here, but last couple of days, there's been a little bit of thunderstorm action, a little bit of rain action. Like around the different spots. All right, what do we do with the rest of the day now? It's still early, look where the sun is. We got all kinds of daylight action left. Gotta find a poker game. Probably gonna need to find lunch. Today is starting off already way better than yesterday did. Got some walk sign action going. Got some sidewalk action going. What else kind of action we got going? Oh shit. Car washes suck. Look at that. Look at that. Can you see it? Look at it. Look at it. Here's the worst part. That's the worst part. Still looks a lot better than it did. Oh well. You know what? Sometimes you're just in the mood for Thai food, even if you had it a couple of days ago. Drunken noodles action.
Thank you.
Sometimes you're just in the mood for Thai food, and that Thai food might happen to be drunken noodles with shrimp. It was really good. Spicy number three again. Now I know. Day Thai, for me, spicy number three. That rhymes. One more attempt to explain to people that it's not complaining when I do a food review or a review of an establishment for you guys, whether it be a poker room or a restaurant or whatever. Do you know how many people have eaten Dirt Dog because of this vlog? I said, do you know how many people have eaten Dirt Dog as a result of this? What about Pizza Rock? Do you have any idea how many people have gone to Pizza Rock because I told them that it's fantastic? So why would I tell someone that something is good when it's not? Why would I tell someone who watches the videos to go eat somewhere and spend their money? People are so, you know what? I think that basically where we are here is that people, it's hard to know who is writing the comments, right? The comments on the YouTube videos, you don't know who's writing it. Is it somebody who's just completely off their rocker? Is it someone in a mental institution? Is it, what is it? A serial killer in a basement, maybe? But I try to think of the videos being for everyone who watches them. So those people who like to go, man, you complain about this and that and whatever, bitch, listen. This is my money, all right? This money right here is all my money. Belongs to me, not anybody else. And for me to choose to spend this money at an establishment, it's a meaningful transaction to me. Every transaction that I make is meaningful because I put work into all of this money. All of this money came from work. I worked my nuts off for this. All right, and when I choose to give a little piece of it to an establishment for a corn dog covered in potatoes and then end up with a rice cake dog thing that's cold in the middle and tastes like shit and I throw it in the dumpster and they have an attitude about it, then I'm gonna tell my viewers about it. So if you don't like it, what you should do is you should work your nuts to the bone and then take all of your money and go spend it at Crunchies and buy all the fucking fucked up cold corn dogs you can get your hands on. How do you like that, bitches? To be clear, when I say bitches, I'm talking about mostly dudes who whine and complain in the comments that I complain too much. Well, I consider your comment a complaint. And I'm not saying you shouldn't complain, but I'm saying that what you were complaining about is invalid. Speaking of sparkly pops, something went wrong with this particular sparkly pop. I don't know what went wrong with it. There are very, very few rejects anymore. There was a margarita reject today, only one out of dozens and dozens of margarita pops that were made. But there's a reason that Christina doesn't want any rejects to fall into the hands of anybody other than me and maybe her. Even though she doesn't really eat the rejects, I eat the rejects. Because we don't want, even for free, for you to get a shitty sparkly pop at all. So They're very intertwined. The corn dog conversation is very intertwined with the reject sparkly pop conversation. More than likely, the people who think I complain are probably some kind of booger picking. Hold that thought. Booger picking, ass scratching, shit for brains employee in the back of the house at a Burger King in the middle of Kansas somewhere, giving people shitty food and shitty service and taking their money and cheating them. Yeah, might as well just run in without letting the people come out first. Makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? That was a complaint. That was a complaint about people and their manners in 2021. Etiquette. Etiquette is the word. Elevator etiquette, escalator etiquette, sidewalk etiquette. That's one thing I hated about working at the Link. When I first had Wahlburgers, I couldn't give you an honest review. I wanted to tell you that the burger sucked and the service was awful, but I would have gotten fired. Tougher to find a good poker game, or a poker game that isn't like somewhat annoying. What is that? Oh, it's an Uber. It looks like an Uber gift card. You think there's anything on it? Actually, I'm pretty sure that's just a room key for Harris. A hotel room at Harris. I mean, I guess the game was okay. I'm probably misrepresenting the poker game I was in tonight. It just wasn't a lot of fun for me for some reason. And I didn't really get a lot of hands or a lot going on. I did win $89. Did I mention that the food at Day Thai was really good again? Spicy number three. Spicy level number three. I love it. I guess we'll have to wait until Trooper Thursday to have a really fun poker game. Shout out to Wisconsin Tom, who I saw in the poker room at Aria tonight. You remember Wisconsin Tom, the guy with the cow pies and the beef sticks and the damn bratwurst and the damn cheese curds. Wisconsin. He'll be at Trooper Thursday. At least he should be. He said he would be. Yo, that's going to do it for the vlog number 83 in a row. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'm going to see you next time, probably for vlog number 84 in a row.